These items, as well as those items that were taken by the Massachusetts Historic Commission earlier in this year, are considered property of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. They notified the town of Plymouth for that this past year. These items right here are presently under temporary custodial agreement with the Massachusetts Historic Commission. Through the end of the present tourist season, which ends, of course, on Thanksgiving, the town of Plymouth passed through its Historic District Commission through Board of Selectmen and the Town Manager's Office, indicated to the Historic Commission and the Secretary of State and to our legislative delegation that these are very important and vital artifacts and are part of certainly national history and Plymouth history, and that it is our desire that we continue to display these items in the town of Plymouth and in the 1749 Courthouse Museum. Again, we'll be in negotiations hopefully soon over the more permanent custodial agreement for these artifacts. Again, in November, the state will come and take custody of the items. They will do whatever is necessary in terms of preservation and cataloging these items. They'll also provide us with an inventory of those items that they did remove from the 130 Cush Street Rear Building. As part of the custodial agreement, we will have to certainly upgrade our display case, and they're willing to provide us with there are some other items upstairs in this chest. I'd like to take everyone upstairs just to show you what other items we do have from party committees. Some of them are privately donated pictures of
Hello, my name is Eddie Johnson, president of the Parting Ways Project, a nonprofit organization that's dedicated to the collection of African American history from Plymouth, Massachusetts. In 1792, the town of Plymouth deeded 106 acres of land to four African American Revolutionary War veterans, Cato Howe, Plato Turner, Kwame Nkrumah, and Prince Goodwin. The homes that these men built would later be known as the New Guinea Settlement.
Hello, my name is Wayne Barboza, and I'm a board member of the Parting Ways Project. I first got involved in 1999 when Eddie and I was traveling to Washington, D.C. for the Me and Man March. On our trip down, we discussed the 5,000 black Americans who served in the Revolutionary War of 1776. I learned that four of the 5,000 soldiers came from the town of Plymouth, Massachusetts, where they lived, worked, and died. Their final resting place is called Parting Ways.